Many of you know it's been a long time in the making, so welcome to Lighting 3. This is actually the third course in our Location Lighting Mastery series, and it's all about creating incredible images that will make you stand out from the crowd. So stick around. This is a trailer, but you're gonna see a lot of behind the scenes moments and techniques that are gonna make watching it worth your time. All of our techniques are demonstrated using a variety of highly portable gear and light modifiers, and they also include what we call power translations. This is so you can know the exact power settings used and how to recreate the same light with any flash or modifier that you already own. In addition, every lesson includes exercise files as well as the education to take these images from shoot to post. We're actually going to work through each of the final images that you see here together. Now, fair warning, as an advanced lighting course, it's packed with content and it's rather fast-paced as it builds upon the knowledge that you've gained in Lighting 1 and Lighting 2. So with that, just be ready to dive in, and if you haven't seen those courses, I'd highly recommend checking them out first. You're going to walk away from this course with light patterns or recipes that you can use to create incredible images no matter the scene or situation. We start things off with multi-point light stacking. The purpose is to essentially fill a scene while adding an additional light to pin our subject and create depth and painterly editorial portraits that you see here. I'm gonna reiterate, Lighting 3 is about anywhere, anytime, getting amazing images. In fact, we're demonstrating many of these techniques in rundown alleys. We're shooting under bridges and in a concrete jungle. In fact, one of our models literally asked,
"Can you make this spot work?"
The answer, yes. You're gonna walk away with lighting and special effects techniques to create amazing images that are gonna blow people's socks off anywhere. We're going to dive deeper and add additional lighting for rim lighting and edging. We'll be using our strobes for creative effects and starburst light patterns like you see here. Once we've gained more comfort in controlling our subjects, our composition, and multi-point light setups, we're gonna be adding a bit of extra complexity by incorporating motion into these environmental portraits via shutter drags. These are the images that will make your work stand out. They're images that you, your clients, your subjects, everyone is going to want to print and hang in their home. In addition, many of the shots that we're creating would be impossible or even unsafe for your subjects. For example, we weren't allowed to take pictures of our couple underneath the parking structure. I wanted to capture this light fixture as a leading line going into the couple standing underneath it. Since we couldn't shoot there with a couple, I just grabbed a quick snapshot of that light. Later in the day, I stood my couple underneath a doorframe and lit them, and using an in-camera double exposure, layered it with that earlier shot. Here's another example. To get this photograph of Heath and Gina underneath this bridge, it would have been incredibly unsafe given that they would have had to stand in the middle of a busy road. So on the sidewalk, I took a shot of Heath and Gina separate. In fact, you'll notice a nasty grate directly behind them. Then I went to the crosswalk, pushed the button, waited my turn, and when it was safe, I walked into the crosswalk and got this shot of the bridge to create our final double exposure. Lighting 3 is all about taking what you're seeing in your mind and being able to create it in camera. Learning how to backlight rain and air particles to create dynamic images, even adding in your own. Creating your own unique special effects flares midday by firing the flash directly into a misted lens against a stucco wall, for crying out loud. Using light composites to paint and create unique images, creating a beautiful wrapping backlight in the middle of nowhere where the natural light looked like this, and our final shot is what you see here. Then learning how to take that image and create a clean and crisp, beautiful textured double exposure. Oh, and one of my favorites is actually when we use an ND filter to split a scene into daytime versus nighttime in a single photograph, where we're gonna add light to our male subject and then create a faux sun coming through the top of the frame. Thousands of photographers around the world have held Lighting 1 and Lighting 2 as the gold standard in location lighting education. And since then, we've become the official educational partners of MagMod and ambassadors and educational partners for Profoto as well. Plain and simple, we love teaching about lighting, and we know you're gonna love Lighting 3. To learn more or purchase, click the link below in the description of this video. My name is Pi, and as always, thank you for allowing us to be part of your creative journey.